Any plans for Friday night?
You can party.
I know how to throw one hell of a party.
We got a party now!
I'm ready to party!
Okay, party people!
Start the party.
Let's party!
Really gotta get all dolled up for a party.
Party, party,
party,
party,
party,
party,
party,
party,
party,
party,
party,
party,
party.
Enjoy your last look at my ass, because I'm gonna party it off!
Everybody knows it's party time.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to NSS. This is the Reynolds Report. Ryan Lochte has been suspended for 10 months over the Rio gas station incident. Lochte was handed the suspension Wednesday by the International Olympic Committee, the United States Olympic Committee, and USA Swimming. Lochte apologized last month in response to his claim that he and his teammates were held at gunpoint during a night out. When asked to comment, Ryan said, 10 months? That's almost half a year, isn't it? When you compete on Survivor, you are not only playing against other contestants, you're also playing against Mother Nature. Producer Jeff Probst says the entire cast from the upcoming Survivor Millennials vs. Gen X had to be temporarily pulled from the game due to a cyclone in Fiji, where production was filming. Tropical Cyclone Zena hit on day two of the game, forcing production to scramble to ensure the contestants' safety. I don't know. It's called Survivor, isn't it? Apple announced the new iPhone 7 yesterday. It features an improved camera, faster processor, and best of all, Nothing by U2. Still, according to Apple, it can do things that no phone has ever done before.
The new iPhone 7 and 7 Plus are more powerful than you could possibly imagine. A longer battery life, waterproof, dustproof, more memory, better graphics, an unbelievable camera. The iPhone 7 cooks perfect bacon. It can shake the dew off the lily when you go wee-wee. The iPhone 7 can play hot for teacher on the drums. You can use it to iron clothes. Play frisbee with your golden doodle. The iPhone 7 can remove dark circles from under your eyes. Change a flat tire. Freshens breath. It can even shoplift a waffle iron from Walmart when you're not looking. The new iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. It's the future. Bitches.
Apparently, Kanye West beat the Pope's record for selling merchandise at Madison Square Garden. But to be fair, the Pope doesn't sell anything with Kim Kardashian's ass on it. Cops in Ohio raided a teenage Amish party and arrested 75 people. They were charged with underage drinking, resisting arrest, and barn raising under the influence. Apparently, things got so crazy, someone turned on a light. Some experts think we're closer to World War III than ever. And here we are without Patrick Swayze. We are screwed. Yeah, I hear ya. You loved that Red Dawn reference, didn't ya? The new military leader of ISIS was apparently trained by the United States government, which means his skills are below par, and he probably demands a lot of smoke breaks. Hashtag not worried. Donald Trump has unveiled his plan to destroy ISIS by boosting the military. And Hillary Clinton has revealed her plan to destroy ISIS by coughing on all of their leaders until they get sick and die. Fox News abruptly removed Greta Van Susteren from its TV lineup and then removed all trace of her on the network's website. It's as if she never existed in their world. Kinda like the way Taylor Swift breaks up with a guy. She just ghosts the dude. Meanwhile, as you probably heard, Taylor Swift and Tom Hiddleston have split up. In other shocking developments, Chelsea Handler posted a topless photo, President Obama played a round of golf, and people in the Middle East got into an argument. A former Chipotle employee claims that workers were expected to show up without pay on their days off to participate in what the company called cleaning parties. Oh, and don't forget that Saturday night is our big all-night dishwashing rave. Time for Nobody Gives a F**k. Gwyneth Paltrow said she regretted announcing her conscious uncoupling with Chris Martin. Then someone reminded her of how much attention she got from that, and she was like, oh yeah, never mind. Hey, Gwynny, nobody gives a f***. Shia LaBeouf says shooting Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull was an extremely unpleasant experience. So, evidently shooting the movie was a lot like watching his performance. Hey, drunken idiot, nobody gives a f***. And Daniel Craig has been offered $150 million to return for two more James Bond movies. Good for him, said everyone with a bachelor's degree earning less than minimum wage. Hey, overpaid, almost mediocre actor who whines a lot. Nobody gives a f***. Thanks, everybody. We have a new episode of The Reynolds Report for you every weekday. Be sure to check out NSS Live, starring Frank D'Angelo and his celebrity talk panel featuring hockey legend Phil Esposito, every Tuesday and Thursday right here on NSS.